What is going on, ladies and gentlemen? This is TomTuffnuts coming at you with our first initial reaction to Miss Katrina Velarde. I've never heard of this young female, it looks like, but we've had a lot of people down in the comments from various reactions we've done, and this name has came up more than once, more than twice, more than a dozen times, and we are finally here. She's been on my list for a couple weeks now, and I'm here to finally react to her. And the most common song that I've seen was the song Burn. I think it's the song Burn. I'm not sure. It just said Burn afterwards, but we're going to go with that. And I see from this thumbnail she's impersonating three different singers. Curious to see who she's impersonating. That'll be interesting. But yeah, I don't know what kind of music we're about to get into here or what it's going to sound like, but man, I'm ready to check it out because you guys never steer me wrong when it comes to checking out really, really talented musicians, singers, artists, whatever it may be. So I'm trusting you once again, ladies and gentlemen. But anyways, do me a favor. Feel free to like and subscribe. That way I know you enjoy this type of content and we can continue reacting to Katrina as well as other various talents that we have here on the channel. But let's go ahead and check this out. Katrina Velarde, Impersonating Singers 3, Burn. Okay. Do I have to guess who she's impersonating?
We don't have to worry about nothing. Cause we got the fire and we're burning a little the something. They're gonna see us from outer space, light it up, like we're the stars of the human race,
Is this the original, like, the song's Burn, this is the Ellie Goulding song, right? I know I've heard this song before, it was all over the radio, I don't know how long ago that was, but I have heard this song a lot, but she sounds exactly like the person that's singing, that's the original singer of this song. So I assume that's the Ellie Goulding. But wow, okay. That's like about as perfect as you can get. But let's see who else we got. It's a good song too, by the way.
When the lights turn down, they don't know what they heard. Strike the match, play it loud, give it love to the world. We'll be raising our head, shining up through the sky, cause we got the fire.
Oh my God. How do you go from that soft, it's not even like a whispery voice, it's just like a very soft, quiet voice, but really nice range. Then you go straight to Shakira. Oh my God, I can't wait to find out who's next. Dude, the Shakira it's right on too. Holy crap. Let's keep going. Oh wow. Shut my mouth. Okay. Listen, I'm at that age, okay? I've been around for a while. I'm basically old as dirt at this point. But I'm familiar with Mariah Carey. I grew up and she was huge, especially in the 90s. She was massive. But she had one of those voices that was so unique to where she could do what she just did. Like, I don't know. I don't know of any other singers that did it before her specifically to where it's not a squeak. I don't know what you guys would call that in vocal terms. But she's the only one I remember and only one I remember still that is capable of doing that. Like, that was what made Mariah Carey. She's got a great voice, but that little change in her vocal capability is what really like set her apart from everybody else. But wow, like if I closed my eyes and heard that, I would 100% would have thought that was Mariah Carey. Incredible. That was spot on. Wow.
Oh.
Christina. Oh my God. Yo. Oh my goodness. Listen, guys. The 90s is my favorite decade of music. Okay. All these artists that she's singing are bringing back so many memories. And I'll be honest, man, call it a guilty pleasure or not, I listened to Christina Aguilera. I listened to Britney Spears. I didn't know a lot about Shakira, especially. I knew a couple of her songs, but like, she wasn't one that I listened to regularly, but and Mariah Carey, obviously, but that Christina Aguilera was flawless. That was right on, perfect power, in key, everything. That was holy moly. I thought this was only, this must be like part three of her impersonating singers. I thought it was just going to be three impersonations, but what do we mean, five or six, and now we got Britney Spears. I'm already going to say she sounds better than Britney Spears, because Britney Spears is like, nothing against her. I don't want to be rude, but most of her live performances were all lip synced. Granted, she did choreography and stuff, but I mean, come on. I just don't know any performances where she actually sang, but she had a good recording voice. This is incredible. Who's next? It is hard for me to sit and listen to this. And I mean that in a good way. Like, I am just like, I just want to walk out and just like let my head explode. I mean, a couple things here real quick. I know you guys hate pausing. I can't help it. I've never seen something to this extent, especially when it comes to impersonating. Like, I love impersonations. I love them, especially when they're really good at them, obviously. But two things, like, one, being able to do an impersonation is incredible, but being able to, like, at the flick of a switch, like, between, you know, you got one line of it being Christina, next line's being Beyonce or whatever it may be, but like just going through those voices, every line of the song is really, really incredible. And I think that'd be pretty difficult to do. But also, I'm assuming that's her daughter sitting on her lap, but like, man, what's her daughter thinking about something like this? I mean, what, she's probably two, maybe. But it's just like, man, I wonder who mommy is going to be today, right? What kind of voice she's going to have. That's incredible. I'd love to hear. I'm curious if, like, she has her own voice as well. You guys will have to let me know because, man, this is incredible to listen to. But let's bring it home right now. This is amazing. Great recommendation, everybody. And we got a five. Oh.
Bye.
oh my God, my body is numb, man. When she hit those Mariah Carey notes, especially at the end, man, I just shivers. Oh my God, wow. I don't know what else to say about this lady. Who is she? Where'd she come from? I'm assuming this is kind of like what she does. I'm sure, well, this is her YouTube channel that I found this on. But man, I kind of want to check out and see if she does any other impersonations. I'm always just like amazed that people can do those things. Like I can do a couple, but nothing incredible. No cool voices. But those, every single one of them were perfect. The Christina Aguilera one just absolutely blew my mind because that was, I mean, that literally sounds like her. The other ones were very, very close, if not perfect. The Mariah, there's just so much in only under 4 minutes. Incredible. But yeah, I'd be curious if she's got some stuff of her own originals maybe, because, I mean, whether you're copying a voice or not, like, you clearly have to be able to sing, and she clearly has the pipes. So I'd be curious to hear her original voice and see what that sounds like. But anyways, guys, thank you so much for this incredible recommendation. Wowee, that's amazing. damn, I felt like my eyes were about to pop out there. That song, that was just not expected. But anyways, guys, thank you so much for watching. I'm Tom Toughnuts. Hopefully you enjoy this reaction as well as listening to this incredible, incredible talent being Katrina Velarde. I don't think this will be the last time we see her, but just in case, feel free to like and subscribe. That way I know that you guys enjoy this and we can continue on our journey with Katrina because, man, I would love to. But anyways, guys, thank you so much for watching. Take care, my friends. Be safe and goodbye.